The forge is empty. No tools. Any idea why?
No tools? That's strange.
Why would your husband take tools with him? Why would he take all the tools with him?
I don't know.
Here's the thing. In your forge, I found a puddle of salt water. Any idea how it got there?
Wait. You went into the forge without asking?
The door was open. Also, there was a puddle on the floor, which turned out to be salty.
Well, it's rude, but this time I'll let you off. The forge uses a lot of water, but that doesn't explain the salt.
Could it be seawater?
I suppose he could have hauled the water from the beach.
So, what's the chatter?
Bad news travels faster than good. What would you like to know?
How's life about the place?
We're doing our best to make things work. The beast is worrisome, 'tis true. But thick skin knows what's what. I'm sure we'll be fine.
What think you of thick-skinned Newsmith?
She ain't perfect, that's for sure. But she's independent, fair-minded, strong in body as in character. She cares for us. I know it in my heart, even if she doesn't show it. Why else would she shield us from the beast?
What can you tell me of Kate Newsmith?
I like her. She's different from her sister. Sensible. Watchful. When she speaks, I listen.
To the point, madam. Kate Newsmith worries for you, and for your husband too. He around?
Fortune left some hours ago and hasn't come back. I confess I'm beginning to worry. What if the beast got him?
Did he not say where he was going?
Thickskin has him making nails for the stockade. She presses him, and he feels the weight of it.
Did you fight?
We're best friends. We don't fight. He's a good man. He never lies. He'll put you at your ease, and before you know it, you're laughing. He is also devout. Almost forgot. It wasn't always so. Coming to New Eden saved us. It saved the marriage.
I should go look for your husband.
He's no woodsman, so he can't have gone far. Please, do find him. I didn't come this far only to lose him now.
Can I have a look around your house?
Yes, if it helps.
Thank you for your time, Mrs. Eden.
Welcome. I've enjoyed our chat. It's nice to have someone new to talk with.
a feeling about the bed. Old emotions are trapped here. Here and now, I lift the curtain.
No. No. Not yours.
That's no ghost threatening Nelly. That's her husband.
It seemed that he was fighting the urge to hurt her. So the blacksmith has gone missing with his tools.
And a saltwater ghost haunts the forge. Let's go find it.
Footprints. Tackety boots with hobnailed soles.
They're stained. I think I can uncover the traces. Let's see if the trail leads to our blacksmith. A moment.
Well, that's handy.
Imagine all those years hunting ghosts, how much time we could have saved. Come on, let's go find our blacksmith.
What think you of the blacksmith and his wife?
A ghost haunts Fortune Heaton and his smithy too.
Aye, but whose? Did you feel that?
It's close.
Pray for me.
Come out. It's safe.
Are they gone? Thank you, whoever you may be, for whatever you have done. I thank you. I thought I was done for. Fortune Heaton, sir, and so very pleased that you came along.
Red MacRaith, the banisher.
Weren't there two of you?
There were, yes. As it happens, I've been looking for you.
You have? What for?
So, you're the blacksmith. What's that like, then?
It's all right, I suppose.
You busy?
Yes, of course I am. Lots of building work to be done. That means nails, whole lot of nails, like an ocean of stupid bloody nails.
I love when a man takes pride in his work.
How are things at Nelly?
Good. Yeah, good. It's, nice. Having a wife. A home. Nelly is, a fine woman. Clever, brave, generous, and kind. She's a blessing.
How did you meet?
Meet? How did we meet? Well, you know, we just, met.
Does he not remember? Or does he not want to say?
Come now, Mr. Heaton. No need to be embarrassed. A wee bit of romance is good for a man.
Romance? It's not. I helped her with a thing. She helped me with a thing. We stay together, helping each other with things. Doing right by one another can bring a couple together. Doesn't always need romance.
I heard you praying. I thought I recognized the text.
You did? Sure.
Nelly painted him a pious Puritan.
Aye. Thought they sounded Catholic.
Oh, well, just coincidence? Look, here's the truth. I'm a convert. I did it for Nelly. I was Catholic. It was a convenience more than a calling. Keep it to yourself, please. I need to fit in around here.
Not my business. I won't tell a soul.
Thank you. That's twice I owe you.
What are you doing out here anyway? Do you not fear the prowling beast?
I needed a walk, a bit of fresh air, a bit of light. Forge is, well, it's dark and hot, isn't it? I didn't mean to be a worry.
We all enjoy walking the woods while burdened down with smithing tools.
Why did you bring your tools?
Yeah, why did I bring my tools? Why? Because they're wanted. That's why. I'm sorry, it's just... I'm losing my tiny little mind. And it's them godforsaken tools that's to blame. I start working with them, and then I look up, and half the day's gone, and I am somewhere else entirely, and that's not even the worst of it. When I return to the forge, the work is done. The tools are haunted, and I'm getting rid of them as deep in the woods as I can go.
Ditching the tools won't help. The haunting affects the forge, too.
Then I'll stay out of it. I can find another blacksmith. Thick-skinned nails will have to wait. Can you help us, Mr. MacRaith?
Yes, I can help. Head for camp. I'll take a look at the tools. Once they're safe, I'll follow.
Yes, sir. Absolutely, sir. Thank you, Banisher. I'll... Thank you.
memories from the past linger here.
Mine! Mine! Mine, oh, mine.
The ghost lays claim to the forge and everything in it.
The flatter from the echo is missing from the toolbox.
If it's not around here somewhere, he lied to us.
Let's see where the back door leads.
Spectral stains, heading deeper into the woods.
Odds are there's a blacksmith's flatter at the end of the trail.
I see the blacksmith has gone.
Enjoying your feast of lesser living form, then.
Don't be so loud. The wisps might hear you and come out.
Stay put.
These body parts scream manifest my spectre.
Present yourself!
Three! More fun!
Watch out! Spectre possession!
I'll get to this one!
Did we miss a few?
Marcin left.
Feel a draft.
From the invisible. Fortune the blacksmith came deep into the dangerous woods.
They who are haunted do odd things.
Maybe the ghost wanted him dead.
If we want to stop for a wee minute, this place will do. Could this be a treasure map? Looks like one.
Maps don't necessarily lead to treasure.
Aye, but what if this one does?
Very well. Let's look for this treasure that obviously awaits us.
Thank you. and ivy again.
As invasive as regular weeds.
You shouldn't stay in there.
The right words of power may force the nearby specters to show themselves.
Corjito Scal.
This isn't over yet. Possession incoming. Think you can take on a ghost? Stop that specter before it possesses the corpse. Not gonna ask for help?
Enough!
This isn't over yet. Harder than that.
Reinforcements!
Ask for help if you need it.
The hammer. Looks like Fortune tried to get rid of it. The hammer is the ghost tie.
Now to retrieve it without breaking my neck.
Yes, that would be a shame. We need to look for somewhere to cross.
I sense a trap.
I sense an echo.
All right then, let's trigger the trap. Right. Good business.
Watch out. Spectre possession.
The invisible.
That's enough, Nelly. I warned you. I warned you this would happen again.
No.
Look at yourself. You're pathetic.
I want a divorce.
You're now Elizabeth Luxford. You are mine. And I'd sooner see you dead and cold than let you leave.
What's going on here?
Walk away, lad. This does not concern you.
I think it does. What do you want to do?
Lovebirds killed a man with his own hammer.
We should talk to his ghost.
Have you unfallach to me?
We are the Banishers Antea Duarte and Red McWraith. Whose ghost are you? Do we really have to listen to this bastard? Nothing good ever comes of talking to the dead.
At times I'm tempted to agree.
Who are you and what do you want with the blacksmith?
My forge. My wife. My name. All mine. The bastard stole them.
Is he telling us our blacksmith's a fraud?
That night, on deck, Nelly asked for a divorce. What happened then?
We saw what happened.
I want to hear him say it. What happened on the boat?
Ungrateful. Scheming. Erin. Oh.
Watch it. Red, come on.
Distempered. Feeble. A weak woman, demanding care and giving none. I gave her a life and she stole mine. She had him kill me.
That's not what I saw.
You've been sowing madness in the mind of the man who replaced you.
She can't escape me.
Are you looking for revenge?
I claim what's mine. She schemed it. He seized it. And I shall have it back.
Why are you here?
I want what's mine. Stolen away. Pride from my grasp. I want my work, my name, my wife.
Your wife is not your property.
She was no one! A drudge who fancied herself a herbalist. I plucked her from the dirt. I made her.
All right, no. I'll not entertain this man a moment longer. I've had enough of this. Let's go. Now we know why Fortune Heaton died.
He's a bastard, but murder is murder. Nellie and her fellow are haunted yet, and I'm concerned for their safety.